Hello and welcome to Faith and Friends. It is Holy Week, starting with Palm Sunday, a reminder of the day that Jesus entered Jerusalem, heralded as a king on a donkey. Then each of the following days after that were filled with events which would lead up to his death and then his resurrection.
It's also Passover week this week, during the actual week when Jesus died on the cross. You can read about Passover. Many historians will say that it was either Passover week or it was moving into Passover week. Regardless, Passover is discussed. They had the Passover meal on that Thursday. You know, think about it as well. There's a lot of times correlation between the Passover lamb and Jesus being our sacrifice, for which we are definitely thankful.
No question about it. Our scripture for the day talks about Jesus being the lamb. John 1, 29 through 34. John saw Jesus coming towards him and said, "Look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is the one I meant when I said, 'A man who comes after me has surpassed me because he was before me.' I myself did not know him, but the reason I came baptizing with water was that he might be revealed to Israel." Then John gave this testimony, "I saw the Spirit come down from heaven as a dove and remain on him, and I myself did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'The man on whom you see the Spirit come down and remain is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit. I have seen and I testify, this is God's chosen one.'" The one that came to declare, "Prepare ye the way of the Lord," saw it all happen. And he said, "Jesus, why am I baptizing you?" But Jesus said, "It needs to be done." And then that amazing thing, "My son, who I'm well pleased," that voice from heaven, just can't imagine that moment in time.
John wrote, "I myself did not know him." But thankfully, we do know him. Thankfully, because of John, because of what Jesus did, we are aware of the sacrifices, and we all have that knowledge now of what Jesus did and what that means for each and every one of us. Mm-hmm.
Well, the week before Jesus was crucified, he spent much time in prayer, especially the night he was arrested. Still today, prayer remains a valuable tool in being connected with God, hearing his voice, and fighting our earthly battles. For the second year, Prayer in the Square was an impacting part of the Converge Youth Conference. I had an opportunity to be there with the hundreds, more than 1,000 people, who spent last Saturday afternoon claiming Lima for Christ. They came from the north, the south, the east, and the west, and converged together in Lima's town square to corporately pray for the government, the schools, the churches, and the city, and to invite God Almighty to be the Lord of their city. It was the second annual Converge Prayer in the Square. Converge attendees had just finished Operation Love Lima, a chance to go into the community and offer the daily bread, as well as the spiritual bread. Next, it was time to gather into the physical heart of Lima and pray, desiring to make an impact on the spiritual heart of the region.
We need an encounter with Jesus Christ. Lima needs an encounter with Jesus Christ. We just passed out 60,000 pounds worth of seed. We gave them the food that perishes, but you are the living bread. And we pray that everybody that eats that food, that there would be a hunger that arises on the inside of them.
That hunger was evident within many attending the prayer in the square. High school students, pastors, community members, all together as one, calling out to God for an end to violence, drug addictions, family issues, racial disunity, and calling for revival.
If you marched in from the north, I need you to say this: revival, come forth. Revival, come forth.
The power of the Holy Spirit will begin to move through each and every one of us, and that we will begin to change this world. And regardless to what strategies or whatever thing that the enemy is trying to do, the power of the anointed and the appointed in this country will begin to move this world in a different direction. So, Father, we thank you for your power. We thank you for your might. We thank you for Christ that rests on the inside of us. We thank you for the blood of Jesus. And we pray, dear God, that you continue to release your authority in this country.
After prayer, it was time to praise. And at Converge, that means celebrating Jesus Christ. It was a party in town square, singing, dancing, continuing to proclaim God as the one true risen King who is able to defeat death and the devil.
Everybody get ready.
Thank you.
in the Square was a small but mighty part of Converge 2017, the youth conference that drew together hundreds of 8th through 12th graders from Ohio and other states. These teens spent 2 days being challenged by national speakers Ben Stewart and Chip Dean, worshiping through song with bands 16 Cities and The Digital Age, attending breakout sessions, praying for one another, and preparing to answer the call God has for their lives. Plans for Converge 2018 are already underway. To find out more or learn how you can use your talents as a volunteer at this event, call Teens for Christ at 419-224-8336.
There are so many impacting things we can share about the recent Converge conference, and we will do so in the coming months. But something new was the Converge Choir. Friday night, dozens of choir members from area churches came together for a special time of singing. Here's one of the two songs they performed, featuring soloist Destiny Burke.
Before I ever cry.
amazing performance there, and we'll have more from the Converge Choir in the coming weeks on Faith and Friends. Well, it's time now for part two in our series, Fully Alive. Last week, Donna Kretsch talked about a grave diagnosis she received and the lifestyle changes she made to once again know what it means to live fully alive. This week, Donna talks about stress. Is stress making you a mess?
Is stress keeping you up at night? Are you having trouble sleeping, or are you just struggling every single day of your life with stressful situations? I'm sure if that's not describing you now, it has in the past, it will in the future, or maybe it is describing exactly who you are every day of your life. Well, I have some great news. That's not God's intention for your life. God wants you to live fully alive, and that means figuring out a way to be able to sleep at night and a way to make sure that stress is not overtaking your entire life. Donna Kretsch is joining us again today, talking more about how God truly has a path to allow us to live fully alive. Last week we heard about your story, Donna, incredible death to life story in reality. And now you have an opportunity to share everything you've learned so that others have this opportunity as well. A lot of people are having trouble sleeping at night, and it can be, stress is a big factor.
Boy, listen, it almost sounds cliche, but stress is making us a mess. Stress is making us a mess, but we don't know it, right? It's like we said last time we talked, folks aren't telling us, and if they're telling us, they're not telling us what to do about it. So one of the first signs that you could be dealing with some hormonal issues is, in fact, the condition of or the quality of sleep. Now, funny thing about adrenal fatigue, exhaustion, burnout, is that if you're dealing with some adrenal stuff, it will show up in sleep deprivation. But the thing is, sleep deprivation will cause adrenals to be a problem. So if we've got stress going on in our lives and therefore it affects our sleep, that can affect our adrenals poorly, which then begin to affect our health and our weight and our wellness and our yada, 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 right? Just big stuff. So the real thing to remember with stress, and the hormone is cortisol, okay? When stress rises in our body, now it could rise due to a food, we'll talk about that in another segment, but it certainly could rise because of emotional or mental situations. So when stress rises, the body goes into the state of raising the cortisol level. So stress goes up, cortisol goes up. But here's the thing, which used to be a good thing, right? It was intended by God
for
it to be
a good thing,
yeah. You know, back in the day when the caveman is running away from the bear to save his life, well, listen, his adrenals are pumping and cortisol is pumping so he can get away from the bear. And when he got away from the bear, he was able to go,
Now,
we don't ever get away
the
from the bear.
Now the bear is life.
Yes.
Yeah.
We never get away from the bear now. So stress is going up. Cortisol is going up. It hits a point where it can't produce anymore. The body just can't do it because it wasn't intended to, right? So then what happens for ladies is cortisol then comes down, figuratively, and steals from progesterone levels. So now, in order to keep cortisol pumping, progesterone's going down, which means estrogen is now dominant. It's supposed to be here. Men don't get off easy. It doesn't steal from their progesterone, but it steals from their testosterone. So now hormones just are whacked, and you feel lousy. Okay, that's long and short what happens. Now you can't sleep. So you had stress that made you not be able to sleep. Now you've got cortisol being affected, adrenals being affected. So now you can't sleep because adrenals are affected. I mean, it all just comes down to that imbalance that nobody's talking about. And stress is the bottom line demon, and cortisol is the culprit that's causing all the problems.
So Pastor Randy Davis, Pastor Doug Boak, was two well-known pastors in this community, have reasons to be stressed.
Yeah.
When you are a pastor of a large church, it comes along with it. If you're a pastor of a small church, you get stressed.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
there. But both of these gentlemen have experienced changes by realizing there's a deeper reason.
These two pastors have given us the honor of helping them take their lives back. And you're right, Jennifer, it's crazy stress when you're leading any kind of a church, when you're a leader, period. And people don't understand the stress that's involved there. Randy will tell you that not only did he lose 80 pounds, but which is what everybody sees.
Every
right?
time I see him, I'm
right.
just like, wow.
But
wow.
He will tell you that he really had some foggy brain issues. He had some issues with trying to remember what was supposed to happen next and somebody's name or a situation or where he left something. And his biggest benefit was a clarity of mind. Well, that is a direct result of balancing out that cortisol hormone level. And he said, I just don't get wrecked like I did You know, making a decision, even a huge one, is very easy for me. Doug is hilarious. Doug says he doesn't have his, he goes, monthly moods. He goes, I don't have my male monthly moods anymore. He said, I would have irritability or moodiness, that now I'm just good. I'm just calm. How many of us could be blessed by that?
He's calm without having to have over-the-counter prescription drugs.
No prescriptions. No prescriptions.
That's a neat, point.
We both have a secret love for Relora, though, right? Relora is, in fact, a product, a natural product that you can take. It is referred to as a natural Prozac, but it's all natural. There's no addictive qualities of any kind. And Relora can help with cortisol levels being brought to a healthy place so that your body can start to be in that balanced place of homeostasis, which is where God intended it to be, and that's when it can function optimally.
Now, are there any things that people can do? Obviously, you can direct people to a program that can help them go through all of this, but on the starting point, let's say the cortisol levels are just a big issue, is there anything they can do starting point at home or just to get going to calm things down?
So absolutely, that they can... absolutely. In the evening, an hour before you sleep, no computer, no television. That LED light is highly stimulative, okay? So that's one. Now, we all hear yoga, right? And sometimes we turn up our nose. I did, because remember I said I was the exercise addict. And listen, I'm not anti-exercise now. I love it. I love it. I just have learned there are certain types of exercises that if you are in hormone imbalance, if stress is an issue and cortisol is an issue, there are exercises that will make you worse. And those were the exercises I was doing because I loved them, right? Mm-hmm. They'll make you worse. So you have to have the right kind of hormone correcting exercise in order. So that needs to be done. Yoga is a good one. And again, not just to calm your mind, although yoga will do that, but to strengthen and stretch the muscles and to restore a youthful appearance in a way that doesn't raise cortisol levels. Certainly Relora is something that can be done, clearing the mind, letting yourself, whether it's the morning ritual, which is mine, or the evening ritual, which is a shorter version of mine, and that's just to lay things at the throne of God to say, I know you've put me here to do this thing, and I know your promises are true, so I know you're gonna deliver on them. And I trust you for that, because there's a big difference between having faith in God and trusting God, right? Mm-hmm. And when we lay those things at his throne and we let them go, there's just a sense of calm that comes over you. And we have one member who had awakened every night for 20 years for 2.5 and 3 hours a night. And we got these hormones into balance, and she lost something like 22 pounds in 30 days, which is like a given. That's not even the big
That's
thing.
That's a great bonus.
The big thing is she sleeps through the night every single night. Her husband wakes up in the morning and literally grabs her hand and checks her pulse because he was afraid for the first few weeks like something was wrong with her. So cortisol can be corrected, and then you can begin to feel fantastic. Weight literally just begins to fall off because it's the hormone imbalance that's throwing everything out of kilter. And with Randy and with Doug, mental clarity is there. Decisions can be made easier. The stress levels that you're dealing with don't get to you anymore. And that's a pretty big bonus.
That is the way God has intended us to live, fully alive. We can't get out of the stress of our lives. We're never going to be able to walk away from it completely, but God has a plan so that we can walk through it. Of course, we want to walk through it with him, but he has incredible ways to naturally show us how to get to those places. Well, we have more of Donna's story and more about things like stress and cortisol and all of that coming up in the weeks to come. But if you want more information, if you want to connect with Donna, you can contact her assistant, Alicia at DonnaKrech.com. That's E-L-I-S-H-A at D-O-N-N-A-K-R-E-C-H.com. You can also find Donna at 709 North Cable Road, Lima, Ohio, 45805. You can call 419-224-8446 or go online, 2030fasttrack.com.
Saturday, April 15th, 1 p.m. is Calvary Chapel of Praise's Big Egg Hunt. Many may be drawn to this event because of the eggs, the candy, and the prizes, but those who organize the event want to share about an even bigger prize. Here's a look at last year's Big Egg Hunt.
It was a good problem at Calvary Chapel of Praise the day before Easter. Extra chairs had to be set up, and that still wasn't enough to accommodate all of the people attending the annual Big Easter Egg Hunt. While nearly 6,000 eggs sat untouched outdoors, a packed sanctuary became a party-like atmosphere because there was a lot worth celebrating. There were puppets and music and even a dancing dog. Four blessed youngsters won bicycles, but the most important message involved a man named Jesus and what he did for you and me.
They hung him on a cross, and it wasn't a pretty sight. Jesus cried, "It is finished," and breathed his last. And they sealed it with a very big rock.
But it didn't end there. The story didn't end. He didn't just die in that tomb. He rose again. He came alive just like he said he did. And because he died and rose again, he took our punishment so that we could one day join him in heaven. Because he loves us. And all we have to do is ask him to come into our hearts and forgive us from our sins.
Dozens of hands were raised as Sweeney led the crowd in a prayer of repentance. So many of these families were drawn to Calvary Chapel for an Easter egg hunt, but would be going home with so much more.
You know, we have so much going on in our community locally, and so an opportunity to hear good news is really important, especially at the young age, where my generation went to Sunday school a lot, but today that dynamic has changed, and so our kids don't have quite the opportunities as I did. And so what a better way at Easter time and getting candy and eggs, you know, to share the story of Jesus and his powerful resurrection.
And then it was time to venture out into the sunshine and those thousands of eggs. In no time, the eggs were gone, gathered up by hundreds of kids on site. Next came special prizes and 500 sack lunches. What a glorious afternoon to share the resurrection truth of Jesus with the Lima community.
We take our time to pray for every person that would come in. We provide the opportunity to meet and greet with families that we wouldn't necessarily get the opportunity to come into the house of God and to meet people that are real, that accept them, that are all-inclusive. And so that's the opportunity that we see before us.
Now, this year's event will be different than what you just saw, but it's promised to be just as fun, encouraging, and well worth attending. The Big Egg Hunt takes place Saturday, April 15th, 1 p.m. at Calvary Chapel of Praise, 1601 Rebecca Drive in Lima. If you have questions, you can call 419-229-4475.
Well, April 30th is another day for your calendar, but it's an important day because that's the FCA Spring Banquet. Andy, what's in store for this year's banquet?
We have an exciting year once again where you get to hear great student testimonies on how their lives have been changed by God. And Steve Hagan, the former New York Jets and Cleveland Browns coach, will be in Lima all weekend sharing his story of 30 years in the NFL. His wife is also going to speak to some of the coaches' wives in the area the day before. So it's a great event. You can register at district8fca.org/banquet or email me for more information. Always just a very encouraging time to hear how youth are taking a leadership role in their faith journey, but then also their schools and how they're going to turn that into a college experience that's focused on Christ.
And you don't have to be attending FCA or even affiliated with FCA to attend this, right?
That's correct. Anybody. It's open to anyone. Just register online so we can get you a meal.
Well, the Spring to Life campaign continues throughout the month of April. On our way to raising $70,000, we're almost halfway there, to be used for operating expenses to get us through the summer slump time. And we are certainly thankful for the influx of you who donated in the last week.
Yeah, I want to thank Barbara from Findlay, Patricia from Payne, and Robert and Carolyn from Lima. Certainly very grateful for those gifts.
Also want to say thank you to Judith from Van Wert, Margaret from Findlay, and also Sharon from Findlay. So folks in the Flag City tuning in and being uplifted by Christian programming and good family programming here throughout the area.
I'll be watching for our thank you gift promotions, courtesy of some of the ministries who air programs on our station. In fact, if you have donated and you were expecting a thank you gift but you didn't ask for it, please give us a call and let us know. We don't send it to you if you haven't asked, but if you did send that donation in and you thought, okay, they're going to send this to me, just give us a call and we'll be happy to do that. You know, your donations are certainly such a blessing to us. Donate online at WTLW.com, by phone 419-339-4444, or by mail, or in person at 1844 Beatty Road, Lima, Ohio 45807. Together, we're sharing the message of Jesus Christ to a hurting world.
One final look at our scripture for this week, John chapter 1, verses 29 through 34. John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is the one I meant when I said, 'A man who comes after me has surpassed me because he was before me.' I myself did not know him, but the reason I came baptizing with water was that he might be revealed to Israel." Then John gave this testimony, "I saw the Spirit come down from heaven as a dove and remain on him, and I myself did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'The man on whom you see the Spirit come down and remain is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit. I have seen and I have testified that this is God's chosen one.'" Thank you for joining us this week on Faith and Friends. We'll see you next time.